We had already been using CFCs for several decades before there was even a suspicion that they could damage the environment.
Man-made chemicals used extensively in aerosol sprays and in refrigeration units pose a threat to the fragile ozone layer that shields the Earth from the harmful effects of the sun's ultraviolet radiation.
I think the first question was, what did we do wrong?
I was surprised enough that I double-checked the calculation several times to see how can this possibly be the case.
We had already released tons and tons of these chemicals into the atmosphere. And they drift very, very slowly to the stratosphere. It takes 50 to 100 years.
And in the stratosphere, when they get above an altitude of about 20 miles, they start running into radiation from the sun that is energetic enough to cause the CFC to break up.
You change from a very stable compound to a very reactive one, which are these chlorine atoms.
At the time that this theory came out, there was a popular video game called Pac-Man, and it was this little bubble on the screen, and you would use the bubble to kind of gobble up all these other little bubbles as fast as you could. And that was a useful analogy for what was happening in the stratosphere with ozone. It wasn't just that one chlorine atom destroyed ozone. It was a process that went on and on and on.